Wisconsin ice cream and frozen custard are fresh local favorites, making them a great choice for summer.
That's right. And today we have Julia Nunez, the 74th Alice in Dairyland, to let us know how we can celebrate National Ice Cream Month. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Thanks for having me in the studio today.
Oh my gosh. We are so happy you're here, especially for this occasion. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I know plenty of people love ice cream. I know all three of us do on the couch here. So where can your, why is it so important to know exactly where your ice cream comes from?
Yes, so I highly encourage people to look for Wisconsin ice cream, because here in Wisconsin we have a long history of producing high quality ice cream, and that's thanks to our over 6,500 dairy farms that we have here in the state producing milk, which is then made into ice cream. And actually, Wisconsin, we invented the ice cream sundae in Two Rivers in 1881. Whoa. So this year is the 140th anniversary of the ice cream sundae. So if that's not a reason to celebrate, I don't know what is.
Oh my gosh. Okay, that's a really fun fact. Give me a little history lesson here. So buying local Wisconsin dairy products is delicious and sustainable. And why is that?
Yes, so it's sustainable for a few reasons. One, because when you're buying local products, you're supporting your community. That's sustainable by putting dollars back into our cities here in Wisconsin. Mm-hmm. Another reason it's sustainable is because locally produced products have to travel less to get to the grocery stores and to get to our homes. So I always encourage people to look for those locally produced products.
Awesome. Oh, wow. That's a really good point there. And so, and you're always coming with treats, Julia. So tell us what you have for us today.
So one of my favorite things about ice cream is that it is versatile. You can enjoy it in many different ways, and I wanted to highlight some of those. One way I love ice cream is in a root beer float, or some people like to mix it up, try orange float or with grape soda, and there's a couple of Wisconsin soda brands. I also have a couple of Wisconsin ice creams up here. Another way, malt powder. So if you ever make a milkshake, add in some malt powder. This is made in Colfax, so just over by Chippewa Falls. And that's a great way to kind of mix up your milkshake. And then another way you can celebrate National Ice Cream Month is by making your own ice cream at home. And here I have some ingredients to make a no-churn mascarpone ice cream. It just needs sweetened condensed milk, mascarpone cheese, and heavy whipping cream. You mix those together, stick it in the freezer, and that's a fun way to make ice cream at home this July.
Wow. Okay, that's awesome. So I've made ice cream one time before in like a second grade class. I don't know if it would be as good, but I'm gonna have to try it again. But perfect. So what can viewers do to celebrate Ice Cream Month besides making ice cream and enjoying these delicious treats?
Yes, so one way you can do that, make your own ice cream at home. You can find that recipe on wisconsindairy.org/National Ice Cream Month. And by looking for the Proudly Wisconsin Dairy badge is a great way to know you're supporting Wisconsin dairy farmers during National Ice Cream Month. And again, that wisconsindairy.org/National Ice Cream Month is a great place to find more recipes and learn how you can celebrate more at home.
All right.
Wow, that's so exciting. I'm definitely going to have to try that too. I feel like I'm always doing it as such a big churner, but it's nice to know that you don't have to do all of that work. So
it's super easy. Very fun recipe to make.
Awesome. And of course, make sure you look out for that Proudly Wisconsin badge on all your dairy products. And thank you so much for coming out and joining us this morning.
Thank you so much.